Hey y'all, welcome to the first episode of Cooking with Chef A. Today is gonna be a special day, okay? We're gonna be making one of my favorite dishes coming up as a cook. It's called chicken cacciatore over edamame spaghetti, okay? Very healthy, very flavorful. We're gonna start off by marinating this chicken, okay? But before that, let me tell you what I'm gonna be putting in this dish, okay? So you have your organic edamame spaghetti, okay? It's very flavorful, very tasty. We have some herbs, sage, thyme, basil. We have some kosher salt, red bell pepper, yellow Spanish onion, some unsalted butter, garlic cloves, Italian parsley, crimini mushrooms, plum tomatoes, chicken and vegetable stock. We have some hot pepper, because you guys know I love spicy food, shit, I'm African. Garlic salt, smoked paprika, some white wine. Yes, I'll probably be drinking some of this while we're cooking. cornstarch, AP flour. Okay, I mix both of them together just to give the chicken a little bit crispy. Adobo, sazon. Listen, I'm telling you, sazon. If you know, you know. All right, we got some coriander, some red chili flakes, and some oregano. All right, so y'all ready? Cause I let's start. I'm gonna put this on real quick. I usually don't wear aprons, guys, but I guess this is a whole, I don't know what this is yet. We'll figure it out together though, all right? So what I'm gonna start off by doing is first I'm gonna wash my hands, okay? Hey man, I hope you guys are staying safe. You know, wash your hands, sanitize your hands, all that stuff, okay? Be safe, stay home. If you ain't gotta leave the house, don't leave the house, all right? So we have organic chicken, okay? You can go to the grocery store and buy any chicken that you want, okay? It could be the chicken wings, it could be chicken thighs, chicken legs, chicken breast, okay? If you're trying to be super, 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 super healthy, you can go with chicken breast. But I like flavor, okay? Cooking healthy doesn't always mean your food gotta taste like shit, okay? It really doesn't. Anybody tell you that, they lying to you, okay? So I buy whole chicken because I'm extra and I like to break them down, okay? Kind of keep my scale sharp. So I get this from Wegmans. It's very flavorful by itself. All right, I'm gonna break this down. I'm gonna break the leg, the wing, and then the breast, okay? All right, and then I'm gonna flip this boy over. All right, now we're gonna break it down. Just crack their bones, go to the point. Cut it. All right, I have my bowl here. We're gonna throw the pieces of chicken in there. Okay, I'm gonna set it right here. I'm gonna take the wing off. The wing, got the drum. Go back in there. Second part of the wing. All right, take some of that off. Just want the drum. Okay, go in there. Now the breast is gonna split right down the middle. Find the bone right there in the middle. Go along it. Okay, be careful. Don't cut yourself. Maybe I'll do a class on knife skills later on down the road, just to sharpen everybody's knife skills. These pieces actually have, this is a chicken tenderloin. So when you go to Wendy's or Chick-fil-A and you want chicken tenderloins, this is what it is. It comes from the breast. Throw that in there. I'm just gonna cut it in half because I want small pieces, I don't want big pieces. I want all the chicken to cook evenly, okay?
Okay.
So we're gonna start off with Italian parsley. Let me rest my knife. All right, rough chop, guys. Rough chop on Italian parsley. Chop it however you want to, okay? Perfect. Move that to the side. Now we're gonna chop up some sage. Those stems away. run your knife through that one more time. Set that to the side. Now, just chop up some rosemary. Okay, just take them off the stem. Give that a little rough chop also. Perfect. Move that to the side. Now we have some thyme. I love cooking with herbs, man. It smells so good, especially rosemary. But I think thyme is my go-to though. Thyme just goes with everything. Chicken, steak, pork chop, anything you're cooking savory, you can throw it in there. Seafood, fish, shrimp, lobster, just goes with everything. Pretty sure some of the chefs out there will agree with me. Okay, take that off, give it a rough chop. Perfect. All right. We're about halfway done with marinating our chicken, okay? Have your chicken, wash my hands real quick, or rinse my hands. All right. Olive oil. We're gonna marinate this chicken. Grab some olive oil. This is extra virgin olive oil. That goes right on top. Perfect. Set that to the side. Let's throw all these herbs in there. Nice. Okay. Now, season. Salt. Good. Let's see, what else we're gonna throw in here? We're gonna throw some black pepper in here. Fresh cracked black pepper. All right, red chili flakes, okay? Remember the spice that I talked about? Love me some spicy food. A little bit of coriander, not too much, just a little bit. Probably about a teaspoon, okay? Set that to the side. Ground hot pepper, just a little bit of that. Garlic salt, just a little bit, not too much. It's perfect. Smoked paprika. You can use any kind of paprika you have in your house. That's fine. It's totally fine. Okay. Now, sazon. You don't want to use too much of it. Just a little bit. Just give the chicken a little bit of color. All right. Perfect. Now, I'm going to chop up some garlic. I hope you guys can see that. We'll mix it in a little bit. Okay. Okay, run your knife through the garlic, rough chop, okay? Doesn't have to be pretty, just give it a little rough chop. All right, fun part, mix it all in. Mix that chicken in. Make sure it goes inside, under the skin, inside of the chicken. It's perfect. Okay, so we're just gonna let this sit for about 20 minutes. We're gonna bread it very lightly and then fry it. All right guys, we're back. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna pan fry the chicken, okay? I have this flour cornstarch mixture. Now, the same seasoning that you use to marinate the chicken, okay? So all the dry spices that we use, the coriander, the smoked paprika, the salt, the black pepper, all that stuff, you use the same seasoning for the flour, okay? So you get that extra flour flavor that you're looking for, okay? So, I already have my pot of hot oil, okay? It's hot, it's ready to go. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna dredge the chicken in the flour, but all I'm gonna do, okay, so you wanna coat it very, very light, okay? I don't know if you can see this, okay? Very, very light. You don't want that extra breading, you don't want extra breading on your chicken, okay? So very, very light. And all you're gonna do is pop it right in there, okay? do, so we have a thigh in there. I'm gonna do a breast. Okay, same process. Breast is very, very light. The oil, I use extra virgin olive oil. Wing. Then I'm gonna do, let's see, let's do a drumstick. So that's four pieces of chicken that we're doing right now, okay? Shake off all the excess flour that we don't want, okay? Very light. Throw that in there. I'm gonna wash my hands and I'll be right back. Alright, now I'm gonna show you guys what's going on over here, okay? I'm gonna turn this up a little bit. This is about medium heat, okay? Because I don't want one side to be burnt. I want the chicken to cook evenly, okay? So I want brown. I want to see brown crispy skin all over. Alright? So this is gonna go for a couple more minutes. I'd say let's fry it for about 12 minutes and see how we do, okay? Alright. Alright guys, the chicken is still going. I'm gonna throw in some thyme and I'm gonna throw in some rosemary. So all I'm doing is I'm flavoring that oil with some aromatic, okay? Now while this chicken is going, we're gonna multitask, okay? So we're gonna start cooking our pasta and then we'll make our sauce and then we're done, okay? So for the pasta, just throwing some extra virgin olive oil. Alright, we're gonna season that water up. We're gonna season the water with a little bit of salt, some fresh cracked black pepper. Okay. Just look at that. All I'm gonna do is throw that right on top. All right. We're done with the chicken. Give you a close-up look. See that, guys? Crispy, flavorful, just gorgeous. All right, y'all, pasta's done. So, what are we gonna do, okay? Olive oil. I like my pasta a little bit al dente, okay? So I don't know how you guys like yours, but al dente is always the best way to go, okay? Olive oil, pinch of salt. Let's do two. Okay, fresh cracked black pepper. Alright, we're just gonna leave it as it is, okay? It already has flavor in it, it has a lot of flavor in it, so you just wanna leave it natural, okay? When you're cooking, everything does not need seasoning, okay? You gotta let the natural flavors develop on its own, okay? Onion has its own flavor, basil has its own flavor, you know, edamame spaghetti has its own flavor, so you just gotta let the natural flavor of whatever you're cooking shine, all right? So you're gonna chop up some basil, okay? Some freshness in there. Let's get some freshness, do a little bit more. Not too much, because we're gonna use the rest to kind of garnish our plate once it's done. Okay, let's do a rough chop of basil. And let's throw that in there. Beautiful. So we cook this in water, salt, pepper, and unsalted butter, okay? We got a little bit of flavor in that water. You can use chicken stock if you wanna cook your spaghetti in chicken stock. Either chicken stock or vegetable stock. Choice is yours, okay? So all right, we're gonna set this to the side. And the last thing we're gonna do is we're gonna start prepping for our sauce and we can finally start plating. But before we start all of that, I need me a glass. You can use Chardonnay, you can use Pinot Gris. I don't care what you use, as long as it's white wine, okay? Well, don't use that cooking wine stuff though, because that cooking wine stuff, that's disgusting. All right, just get you a nice, decent white wine, you know, and I'm pretty sure it'll do just fine. Wine, man. A glass of wine keeps the Rona away. It's like, nah, let me stop. All right, onions. Let's give it a little rinse. All right. Make sure your knife is sharp, guys. You can only cut yourself if your knife is dull. Remember that. Well, actually, I lie. You can't only cut yourself if your knife. You have a high chance of cutting yourself if your knife is dull. So make sure you have a sharpener, all right? I got this at Sodatab. You can go to Walmart, you can go to Target and just find your knife sharpener. All it is put your knife through here and the sharpener is for you. That's it. That simple. Okay? Sharp knife. It's the way to go. All right. So, onions. Slice, 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 slice. Your onions. Okay? You want to dice it. Like I said, I'll probably do a video on knife skills later on down the road, just so everybody has sharp knife skills, okay? So, dicing, okay? Then run your knife through it one more time. Perfect. Let's do another. Great. Let's move that to the side. Now, that's my hands. Mushrooms. We got about 4 crimini mushrooms, okay? If you can't find crimini mushrooms in the grocery store, use shiitake, use any kind of mushroom that you want, okay? If you're a mushroom lover like me, don't matter, okay? So all we wanna do is slice the mushrooms, okay? Okay, now, move this to the side. Try and work as neat as possible, guys, okay? Try and be as organized as you can, okay? Just trying to make you guys professional chefs, okay? Show you guys a real easy technique. So what I'll do is make a little incision on the side of the bell pepper with your knife at this angle, okay? And just go around it, around and around and around and around, okay? Done. So, cut this in half. You want to julienne the peppers, okay? So, let's do this. One. I want to say we're only going to use half of the bell pepper, okay? Now, if you're cooking for a family of what, 3, 4, 5, go ahead and use the whole thing, okay? So, all I used was half an onion and half a bell pepper, all right? We're gonna throw that on the side. Now, I think we're about done here, so we can move on over to the hot fire and start cooking. See ya. All right, so now we're gonna start with our sauce, okay? What you wanna do is get you a hot pan, throw some olive oil in it. All right, you can use olive oil, you can use coconut oil, avocado oil, whatever oil you want to use, okay? It's fine with me. So, we're gonna wait for this to get hot. In the meantime, I'll show you guys what I have, okay? You got some mushrooms that's already sliced, peppers sliced, garlic chopped, some Italian parsley, rough chopped, and some onions that's also diced, okay? We have chicken stock and vegetable stock mixture, smoked paprika, red chili flakes, oregano, black pepper, kosher salt, and plum tomatoes, okay? Now you can use diced tomatoes or tomato sauce, however you want. Right. So, actually I'm gonna throw a little bit of butter in here too, guys. Just a little bit, about a teaspoon, okay, let that melt. All right. Now the fun starts. Let me throw this on before it starts to go off. So melt the butter in the pot, okay? Just like that, just melt it, all right? I like my butter to brown a little bit. It gives it an additional flavor that you want, okay? Gives it almost like a smoky, nutty flavor. It's really good. All right, it's called brown butter. All right, let's see. Throw the onions in there first? Actually, no. Let's throw the garlic in there first. We're gonna throw about a teaspoon of garlic in here. Okay, we're gonna cook the garlic. right? You just want it to brown a little bit. You just want to brown the garlic a little bit. All right. Now, something I learned when I was coming up in culinary school, you want to season every stage of your sauce, okay? So, you got your garlic in there. These are all called aromatics, okay? So you're just gonna throw garlic in there, Italian parsley, and your onions, and your mushrooms. So you're gonna season every stage. So if you throw your vegetables in there, you season it, right? And then you're gonna throw your plum tomatoes in there, you're gonna season it. You throw your vegetable stock in there, you're gonna taste first to make sure it doesn't need any seasoning. And if it does need seasoning, you add more seasoning to it, salt, pepper, all right? Okay, so garlic is brown now, smells really good. You're gonna throw onions in there. Beautiful. Give that a little stir. Don't let your garlic burn, guys. If your garlic burns, start all over. You just wanna go to brown, all right? Just like fried chicken. All right, throw the mushrooms in there. Throw your peppers in there. Now, throw about half of this Italian parsley that you have. Okay, so I say I have about 3 tablespoons of, 1 tablespoon of parsley. All right, give that a little stir. Okay, all you wanna do is sweat these vegetables. You don't wanna cook them too much. Again, I like my vegetables also al dente, all right? Season, salt, pepper, about a pinch of salt. All your seasons are gonna go in now. Black pepper, crack that. All right, beautiful. I'm gonna throw a little bit more olive oil in here because the ratio of vegetables to olive oil is off. All right, give that a little stir. Man, this looks so good. I'm gonna throw the smoked paprika in there. Just about a pinch of paprika. I'm gonna throw in some red chili flakes. So I only used about, let's say about a tablespoon of olive, teaspoon of all the seasoning, dry herbs. All right, throw that in there too. All right, give that a stir. Now we cook it. Love it. Okay, I'm gonna bring you guys over here so you can see what it's supposed to look like. What they're supposed to look like. All right. So you want to stir this for about, I want to say about 3 minutes, okay? Don't cook your vegetables all the way, okay? So that's perfect right there. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna deglaze the pan with the white wine that we got, all right? So about half a cup. That looks good, smells good in here too, guys. All right, so we deglaze the pan, so all the stickiness that was in the bottom of the pan, all that stuff that you guys think when you're pan searing stuff is burnt, that's all flavor, guys. You want that, okay? You want that when you're making a sauce. So, all we're gonna do right now is wait for all the alcohol to cook out. A good question to ask me would be, how do you know when the alcohol is cooked out, right? So, you're gonna start seeing bubbles transform it in the pot, all right? You start seeing in the corners. That's how you know that all the alcohol in your sauce is cooked out, okay? You don't wanna cook, you don't wanna eat sauce that has alcohol in it. That's gonna upset your stomach, okay? You don't want that. Cook all the alcohol out and just leave the flavor, okay? So let me show you a little bit. See all those bubbles? That's how you know the alcohol is gone, all right? So I'm gonna reduce this by half. What that means is I'm just gonna let this cook down. All right, guys, so now we're gonna throw, this is reduced. This has reduced by half, okay? So now we're gonna throw plum tomatoes in there. All right. Now all we're gonna do now is break down this plum tomatoes. Let's break it down. Add a little bit of chicken stock that we made earlier, okay? Nice. All right, guys, our sauce is done. This is the consistency that we're looking for.
okay? You don't want it too watery, but you want to leave enough sauce in there for the pasta. All
right, guys, we have officially reached the final stage of the first episode. My favorite part, which is plating. You have your pasta, pretty sure that's the size of my palm, and then chicken. Remember, I'm just gonna go rustic. Alright. Sauce can go right on top of that chicken. Not too much sauce, because you wanna leave that skin crispy. Alright? But you wanna have enough sauce for that pasta. Some white wine. This dish goes really well with white wine, okay? So, here we are, chicken cacciatore with edamame spaghetti. Very nice, very beautiful.